carrying out on down and anti-down quark structure. What did we see so far? I invoked the logic to conclude that if you, as a separate object, have a rest mass, you are some sort of combination of down and anti-down quarks. There is no object that is made of something else, that I think. We calculated the distance at which the electric attractive force is balanced with very strong gravitational force. That is possibility. It was in the region near RC. We concluded that particles can be some sort of photon assembly. Still speculation, but photons have balanced electric charges. We'll see a picture of that. While our D and anti D quarks have surplus in negative and positive electric charges respectively. But then we remembered that we can't expect particle to hold on to all of its electric charge in a very strong gravitational field. In other words, near RC. So if you are near RC, you cannot hold on to your electric charge. Why? Because you lose significant part of your mass. That is the reason why quarks, D and anti-D quarks, are imbalanced. Because part of its charge is lost in extremely strong gravitational field. Okay, all in all, D and anti-D quark, D and anti-D quark should be a sort of mirror image to each other. Photonic in its nature, extremely dense, R close to RC. Why is that? Well, because in these regions, gravity is comparable with electromagnetic interactions, according to my equation, of course, and according to the observation. You know that gravity is the strongest force in nature. You say there is nothing that can escape the event horizon. Whatever you place in near the event horizon, it will break. You know that gravity is the strongest force in nature. You just cannot say that out loud. Okay. All in all, the D and the anti-D quarks should be a sort of a mirror image to each other, photonic in its nature, extremely dense, R close to RC. They have misbalance in its own respective electric charges. And they are expected to have dipole magnetic moments, so they should have sort of circular motion of misbalanced electric charges. Of course, if you're planning to have current that is detectable and that has magnetic moment, that current has to be of charges that are not balanced. Because if you have same amount of positive and negative charges that circles around each other, around the circle, you will have no magnetic moment there. But if you have imbalanced electric charge that sort of circle around each other, we will see what kind of circulation is that. It's not real circulation, but in one hand, but in another it is. That is something else, doesn't matter. So, in our course of ourselves, they have misbalance on its respective electric charges, and they are expected to have dipole moment magnet. So, they should have sort of circular motion of misbalanced electric charges. But not real circular motion, because that would radiate electromagnetic energy wave. So, having all this in mind, now we're gonna try to decipher the quark. The quark. Simplified representation of a photon, D quark and anti-D quark. So, first of all, this is the representation of the photon. I found this image somewhere on the internet and I could not find where. And from memory I did write it down. So, this is the photon, this is the direction of motion. As you can see, there is separation between these electric charges, whatever they may be. I'm not going into that now. And magnetic field here is upward, here is downward. So this is photon is electromagnetic wave, and this is a packet of that, and this is one wavelength, and that is here is nothing new, nothing extraordinary. This is something that is widely known. So electric field goes in this direction here, in this direction here, magnetic field goes up and magnetic field goes down, as the motion of photon is this way. So bear in mind what kind of motion of photon. I don't think that is you have this negative charge that moves straight forward. No. These electric charges oscillate around this point in some way. So they become and vanish. But that oscillation moves in this direction. When that oscillation moves in that direction, or when a photon moves in that direction, this is the electric charges, this is the electric field, and this is the picture of a magnetic field. So this is how photon looks from above. If you look this thing from above, this is what you will see. This is charges, they are same, this is magnetic field, this one is upwards, this is downwards, and these are the charges that are same, and this is the direction of motion. So this is the photon, and this is nothing new. And this is quark. This is the quark, this is anti-D quark. So as you can see, the quark is bent around itself. It moves in circular pattern, similar to this movement of photon. This movement, if this movement moves in this direction, straight, we have balanced charges and magnetic fields. This, the quark, is twisted around itself. It moves in circular motion, in the same manner as this moving in straight motion. So there is not much difference between quark and photon, except their charges are disbalanced and it is twisted, and I say mutilated because this internal electric charge is much smaller than this one. Why is this needed? So because overall electric charge of this thing is not zero. Overall electric charge of this thing is zero because they all cancel each other out, but overall electric charge of this thing is not zero. It is exactly a third of the electron, or one charge of the D quark. And in this configuration, you have balance between magnetic forces, electric, that is magnetic and electric, which are repulsive, and you have gravitational force that hold this whole thing together. And as expected, this here is much more reduced than this one here. Let's say that for time being, because this is much closer to that RC than this one here. Let's say that for that reason. And now this is the charge of the overall sum of these four things is actually that electric charge of the D quark. And very similar, but other way around, is overall electric charge of the anti-D quark. So this is the D quark, this is anti-D quark. So very similar to a photon, just it is twisted around its axis, and this thing moves closer to this one. As you can see, this be straightened up, and because those things are part of these things are very close to each other, that they are held by gravity, and it remain twisted like this. So you could imagine what will happen if you put those two things close together. So I'm not going to say nothing about that. So now you can see you have imbalanced charges. You need to have imbalanced charges because gravitational force, gravitational field here is strong, and it's eating part of these internal charges here and also here, and that's why you have this balance in D quark of the electric charge and this balance in anti-D quark of electric charge, and that's why you have magnetic moments, etc., etc. So this is the D quark, this is the anti-D quark, and everything is made from this, or combination of those two. It's not easy to understand, so I hope now we're gonna do something more about them. But it is important. Okay, in the spirit of all above, we can assume that the quark structure as a twisted, mutilated, self-contained photon, held together and as it is with its own extremely strong gravitational field, where R is larger than RC, so that is attractive gravitational field, and held apart by electromagnetic repulsion. In addition, bear in mind that in its strongest domain, R is smaller than RC, and very, very close to here, gravitational repulsive force has no match. It is an unchanged ruler. Repulsive force. So what will happen if this came too close together? What will happen? That gravitational force will attractive gravitational force will be instantly become repulsive gravitational force and will break this thing apart. Because you will have repulsive electric, magnetic and gravitational force. But let that be for a while. Can't be. Okay, in a picture of a D quark, we see four electric charges, and they are two external negative charges, Q, and two identical positive charges, Q. Exact quantity of Q and Q coulombs is unknown to this time to me, let's say that. But the overall sum is exactly one third of negative elementary charge, see the picture for efficiency calculations. The internal electric charges are subjected to a greater than external rest mass loss, and its result of quantity is reduced more. Now, what is that charge? We do not know for the time being, maybe never know. But all in all, that thing that we detect, that we can measure, is like that. In reality, it is more likely that this electric field is the one that gets reduced, but we observe it as an electric charge reduction. If you observe the name quark from a big enough distance, the star seven around 10 to the minus 14 meters. It is not meters squared, this is a reference, 10 to the minus 40 meters for D quark within a proton. We can't detect these internal positive electric charges within a D quark, and at this larger distance, we observe the quark as one particle with one electric charge of E of minus E third. But other particles that are close enough, they certainly can, for this amount, almost planar, these almost planar imbalanced electrical charges with one D quark, will enable us to consider nuclear and color forces as an electromagnetic interaction that will come. So first scenario. So this is a quark, more or less, that is a sketch of it. So this thing moves in this direction, this thing moves in this direction, let's say that, doesn't matter. So these are the positive charges, these are the negative charges, and magnetic field, as you can see, is directed toward us. And if this moves in this direction, the magnetic field is also directed toward us. So you could do this. My head hurts, okay, thinking. Doesn't matter. So, all in all, that is D quark, this is anti-D quark. I want to tell you something else, but I forget what I want. Well, doesn't matter. So, now we will try to see what is first scenario and so on, so in the next video. First scenario, second scenario, third scenario, we try to iterate this, what is this, how it moves, and to give more detailed and precise picture of these things. But this is what it is.